I heard a well, this was for the Orange Bowl. Remember when we threw oranges on the?
Absolutely.
And also, I heard a rumor that the defensive back, as you went by, said, "Oh shit!" Is that right?
It was not a rumor. I remember it like it was yesterday. As I ran by him, he said, "Oh shit!" And then all of a sudden, I saw the ball coming, and I went, "Oh shit!" And thank God I caught it, because after the game, Galen Hall said, "Zabel, if you'd have missed that pass, you'd have just kept on running."
Well, Bobby, talk about the play and the drive. That was a heck of a drive.
We had to beat Kansas that day to win the Big 8 championship and get the bid to go to the Orange Bowl. And we really hadn't moved the ball well all day. I think it was like 10-0 at halftime. And finally, in the third quarter, we score a touchdown. We make it 10-7. But we're still not doing real well on offense. And in the fourth quarter, our defense finally holds Kansas. They had a great offensive team. Bobby Douglas, Junior Riggins, Vernon Vanoy, John Zook, to name a few. Really had a great team. We held them. They punt. The ball rolls out on the four-yard line. We've got 96 yards to go with about 6 minutes to go in the game. And I'm standing over there by Chuck Fairbanks waiting for the call to come in. And I look across the field, and there's old Pepper Rogers over there, Kansas's coach, and he's throwing an orange up, you know. And he knew he had the game won. We hadn't moved the ball well all game. And Fairbanks gives me the play. It's a little jump pass to Steve Zabel. And I'm thinking, oh, shit.
That's where it started.
You know, we're on the four-yard line, and our formation is such where Zabel's over here on the right, and they want me to make a fake over here and then jump back around this way and hit Zabel. That's pretty hard for a right-hander to do, and I'm running in there, and I'm thinking, maybe I'll just change this formation, put Zabel over here, and I'll fake it this way and go here. It's a lot easier. But I had learned my lesson earlier to not change plays. So I didn't change the play. And we made the fake over here. We hit Zabel, and he goes down to about the 15-yard line. So we got a little running room. So we start pounding Owens in there, and he's picking up some yardage and so forth. And we're beginning to click, and we're beginning to get a little rhythm. And, you know, we hit a pass or two. We hit Killingsworth over there for 8 to 10 yards. And we finally get fourth and one on about the 45. We got to go for it. You know, it's about 4 minutes to go in the ball game, and so we pound Owens up in there. He gets the first down, so we've got drive alive, and we're still going. And finally, we get it down on the 30-yard line, and Switzer makes the call, and it's a fake to Owens off tackle, and we're throwing the ball deep to Zabel. And I knew when we called it in the huddle, and everybody else did, this was it. I mean, this was going to be the play. It's, you know, we're down 10-7. We got about a minute to go in the ball game. And as soon as I went back and planted the foot and threw the ball, I think that was the only spiral I threw my whole career. But Zabel catches it going over right over his shoulder into the end zone, and just immediately, oranges were just pelted the field.
Second down play, 7 yards to go. Warmack takes the ball to Owens. Back to pass, throws deep for Zabel in the end zone.
Each other to death down there ever since, and now they'll never get the oranges off the field. Holy mackerel, I can't believe it.
I mean, I have never seen that field covered with oranges. Matter of fact, we get a penalty, you know. But that was the play that won that ball game, that we won the Big 8 championship, went on to the Orange Bowl to play Tennessee. And I really think that was a game that allowed the coaches to go and recruit, you know, a lot of these great athletes sitting right over here. And that was a great win for our program.